Welcome everyone. Today we're here to talk about the CM41 launch, our new video conferencing camera, USB camera. We're on our Demio platform, and as you can see on the right hand side of your screen, you have the chat window. If you have any questions, feel free to ask those. One of us will be actively monitoring these questions. If we're not able to answer them right away, we'll write them down and come back to you later with the answer. Well, this is the schedule for today. First, we're going to talk a little bit about Avonic as a company. After that, the product overview, and then we are going to dive into the CM41, taking a closer look at how it's built up and what it is capable of. Next up, we will do a live demonstration where you can actually see or actively see the difference between a CM44 and a CM41, as they have different optical lenses inside. And after that, we'll talk a little bit about where you can use the CM41. And as a last point, we will provide you with some takeaway points, a summary, if you will, to provide you with the necessary knowledge to start selling them. Well, Avonic started 16 years ago already as a more traditional AV distribution company. But about 5 or 6 years ago, we started manufacturing and designing PTZ cameras. As we saw that the traditional way of distributing AV products became less interesting. Focus mainly has been on Pro AV installations, and in this time we are distributing our products in more than 30 countries on every continent. So these are our main applications. A couple of important ones, for example, education. The education market has quickly become very important to us during the COVID pandemic. It is actually one of the reasons why the CM41 saw the light of day, because typically educational purposes require cameras that can cover more distance than our CM44s or CM22s. So the need for a 10 or 12 times optical zoom was actually born in the last 1.5 years. And this is one of the reasons why we designed the CM41. Another very important area for us is the video conferencing market, where we mainly provide cameras for city councils and houses of parliament, for example. We have a very good integration with one of our partners, Bosch, for example, where our cameras can be completely controlled through the meeting system. So let's move on to the product overview. On the left-hand side, you will see that the video products, the video conferencing products with the CM20, the CM22 as first one. Next up is the CM40 series, where you go from a fixed installation camera or a fixed camera to a PTZ camera. Then the CM60 series, which is a fixed position camera for fixed installations, and the CM70 series, where a lot of features are required and that perform even better under less than optimal light conditions. So this is it, the all new CM41. As you can see, it has the same backside as a CM44. The main difference is at the top, where the lens is completely different from the 5x optical zoom. It is now a 12x optical zoom, providing a much larger ability to zoom in on people in large boardrooms, for example. Well, here it is in detail. As I said, the CM41 has a 12x optical zoom level, which has a horizontal field of view of 70.4 degrees, where the CM44 has 84 degrees field of view. So the CM44 is actually a little bit wider. The CM41 will be focused a little bit further away. It's got, as all the CM70 series, the smart automatic modes and manual modes for even the most challenging light conditions. Actually, this 12x optical zoom lens is one of the best ones in our lineup. The backlight compensation is supported, so even if you are filming people where you have windows in the back and a lot of backlight, you can have some compensation to get a better result. Controlled can be via different ways. You can use the supplied infrared remote. You can use the more traditional way of controlling it over RS-232 or 485 using the Visca protocol, for example. You can control it over USB using the UVC protocol, or you can use Visca over IP, which is a brilliant way to use it into system integration. It's actually a pretty unique feature in this price point for this camera. For example, Crestron and Extron have drivers for our cameras, so you can easily integrate it into one of those systems. The camera has the ability to have 255 presets, and recently we have added a feature where you can adjust the speed between each preset. So you can lower the speed if you have one camera in the room and you would like to have it move from one speaker to the next one. You can actually have it move at a slow speed instead of the video conferencing as fast as possible speed. So you have the 1080p 30 quality on USB output, and of course this camera is fully compatible with our UEX150 USB extender. So as I said, it is compatible with the UVC protocol, so it supports basically all platforms using those. You can see the examples below: Zoom, Hangouts, Microsoft Teams, GoToMeeting, Mersive, and a couple more. Since yesterday, and nobody knows this at this point yet, is that we are working on support for Barco ClickShare systems. Actually, the image below is from yesterday, where in one of my tests, actually, we have a CM41 working with the ClickShare system. So expect more news on that front soon. The camera can be controlled through Zoom and Zoom Rooms, for example. You can use the far end control in Zoom, or in Zoom Rooms, the integrated system using an iPad, for example. And of course, as this camera makes use of the same enclosure as the rest of our cameras, you can mount it to the wall. It has the protection eye on the left. It's got a Kensington lock. You can install it below a screen, above a screen. You can flip the image. It is a full-fledged PTZ camera. Here's an overview of our video conferencing cameras: the CM22, the 41, and the 44. Where the CM22 is the fixed camera. It has fixed positioning and a fixed lens. Any zooming you do with the CM22 is digitally, where the CM41 and 44 have an actual optical zoom lens. The CM22 can be mounted upside down or normal, below a screen, above a screen. It can be the depth from the wall can be variated. And obviously the CM41 and 44 are full-fledged PTZ cameras with all the possibilities of all the PTZ cameras we carry. So what I've made is a couple of real-life situations where you can actually see how large this difference in degrees creates. So in these little drawings, the C stands for the camera point of view. So you can actually see at the CM44 with the almost 84 degrees field of view, at 5 meters you have a little over 9 meters of width on your screen. If you have a look at the 41 with the 70.4 degrees, you have a little over 7 meters. And the CM22, obviously with the 120 degrees field of view fixed lens, has a whopping 17 meters and 30 centimeters of field of view. Obviously, this is not where the CM41 is to be used. The CM41 actually comes to its strength in the next example. So again, this is a viewing distance of 5 meters with C as the camera point, and you can see that the CM44 roughly brings 1.80 meters onto the screen, and the CM44 is actually capable of doing 60 centimeters width. So you can zoom in a lot further on the object you'd like to film. As I said, the CM22 is a fixed lens, so any zooming you do with this camera will result in degrading the picture. So I've not made the same comparison. As it is a fixed lens, it does not have optical zoom. So right now we are going to do a little live demo where my colleague Steven is going to be the assistant, and we are going to first have a look at fully zoomed out and then fully zoomed in CM44. So there is Steven, you can see him, hello. This is fully zoomed out, and there we go, zooming in. And here you can see this is actually about the 1.80 meter I was talking about earlier, fully zoomed in. And if you zoom out, you can see, you will see on the right hand side a little bit of the curtains, the fire extinguisher, and on the left hand side you'll see the bar stool, which is used during our AV show. This is actually our digital AV booth. So we'll do it one more time to make sure you've seen it correctly. And we are going back to me. So the next one will be the CM41, and you'll clearly see a difference on the zoomed in part. So there we go again. There you go. Steven is a lot closer now than he was before. And if you have a look when we're fully zoomed out, you'll see that the curtains are no longer in the image, the fire extinguisher just, and the stool is only just in the image where it was completely visible in the other example. And once more, Steven up close and personal, and back to me. So I actually have a camera right here next to me, so I'm going to pick it up and we can have a look at what we have in the box when you decide to purchase one. So let's open it up. A couple of important points when you open this up: there should always be a quality control card. In this case it is signed by my colleague Timo. There's a quick guide with a quick overview of the address, the IP address of the camera, for example, or how you should hold it when you take it out, for example. And it describes it right here, not to grab it by the moving parts, as it is actually pretty delicate stuff. So I'm going to come back to the accessories in a bit. Let's move on to the camera first. So gently lift it out under one of the arms, and you will actually see that it is in a seal. It is important if you open this camera for the first time that the seal is not broken, because if it's broken, it means that somebody else has already opened it up. And if there is a problem with the camera, we will always ask you if the camera was still in the seal. So there it is. Let me point it upwards, see if I can make this visible. You can clearly see that the optical part is a lot larger than it is on the CM44. This is everything to do with the fact that this is a 12 times optical lens. So let's move it around and see if we can actually make this visible a little bit. We have the standard connections. This is actually the on-off switch, the power adapter connector, the RJ45 Ethernet connector for the Visca over IP control, the USB connection, the green Phoenix connector for your RS485 connection. The selector switch is actually part of the main PCB we use in the 40 series, but it has no function in the CM41, as the resolution is dictated by the system to which it is connected. And on this end you have the Mini DIN 8 RS232 connections. So that's the camera itself. You can see the protection eye where you can pull the steel cable through to secure the camera if it's in an upside down position. And I forgot, actually, the Kensington lock is right here. So let me put this one down for a second. We move on to the accessories. You can see we supply it with the remote control. The USB cable, USB-A to USB-A connection. There's a USB-A connection on the back of the camera. The other end goes into your computer. In this case, we have the European style power connector and your RS-232 possibility to control it via a computer, for example. And last is the little green Phoenix connector, which goes into the back of the camera if you want to use the RS-485 connection. So let me just put it in like this. And there you go. All ready to go. So that is what you can find in the box. And after that, it's only a question of just connecting the power supply and the power connector, and you're good to go. So we were talking a little bit about the applications before. As you've seen with the example that Stephen was in the image, that you can zoom in a lot further. Actually, 12 times is more than twice the zoom range than the CM44. So you see that you can actually use this zoom range to cover a lot more distance and still bring people into the image in a normal way without having to film like 2 meters wide at a distance of 4 or 5 meters. So this is one example of a large boardroom where actually the CM41 would be very good in place. Well, the online and hybrid learning is something I talked about as well. Again, the 12 times optical zoom is where this comes into play, as typically the camera is in the back of the classroom and it needs to be able to film the teacher and the stuff that's on the whiteboard or on the digital board without having issues of reaching the end of the zoom range. So this is actually the CM44 on steroids. So I think we have a pretty strong product for the education, and in a very short resolution, or how do you say that, recap, it is the perfect solution for any medium or large size boardroom or classroom. So just a few takeaway points as a recap. The CM41 covers a wide range of applications due to its 12 times optical zoom. The horizontal view is like the CM71, 70.4 degrees. It has automatic modes for challenging light conditions. This big piece of glass in the front I showed you is very light sensitive, so you are able to get a very good picture even under challenging light conditions. The backlight compensation is supported. It has the Fisker over IP integration for systems like Crestron or Extron, for example. You have the adjustable preset speed, and you have like 255 presets, so more than enough to cover all the ground you need. 1080p 30 on USB 2.0. And as we said, it's compatible with any room control system. Again, medium and large size boardrooms are where it's at home. So, if you have any questions, as I said in the beginning, you can put them in the chat. The recording will be made available to all the attendees, and the product videos will be are available via our YouTube channel. If you are interested in our products or you would like to buy one, contact your local reseller or distributor via avonic.com where to buy. So, and we have a couple of examples of other videos we have on our YouTube channel, for example. There they are. Do you need more explanation on how to install a COM300? Would you like to read more about or see more about the CM70 series or our technical integration with Roland Video Mixers? It's all on there. And if it's not on there, please send us an email and we'll be happy to answer your questions about these. So that's all I have for you today. I hope it was informative for you. And that's about it. Thanks. Bye bye.